In this video, we're going to solve another circuit using superposition method where this circuit has a dependent source. As you can see right here, we have a dependent current source along with two independent sources, one independent voltage source and one independent current source. Well, the key thing to remember when using superposition method and there's dependent sources involved is that you cannot eliminate dependent sources. So we're going to have two superposition circuits to solve in this case, where one superposition circuit will have the independent voltage source along with this dependent source, and the other superposition circuit will have the independent current source along with the dependent source. Okay, we can only eliminate independent sources. And again, the way we eliminate independent voltage sources is with shorts, and the way we eliminate independent current sources is with opens. So in this problem, we're going to use superposition to find this voltage at node Vx. So the voltage at this node right here with respect to ground. That's what we're after. So let's look at our superposition circuits that we'll have to solve. Okay, so actually, they're on separate pages. Okay, well, here's our original circuit. And here's going to be one superposition circuit with the voltage source, independent voltage source, and dependent source. And then the second superposition circuit you can see right here is going to be with the independent current source and the dependent source. So let's start with solving this circuit here. We're going to keep the bottom node ground as was shown in the original diagram. So this is still our ground here. Okay, so this bottom node is ground. And to solve this, I'm going to use node voltage method. Now, you really only have a choice of node voltage method and mesh current method to solve this problem. You can't use, voltage divider, current divider, and, the techniques we were using before learning about node voltage and mesh current, because we have two sources here. To use current divider or voltage divider, in those techniques, you need a circuit with a single source. And by the very definition, the fact that we have one independent source along with the dependent source, well, it rules out using any of the voltage divider, current divider type of techniques that we were doing. So we're going to use node voltage method. So here's our unknown node Vx. This is known over here. Right, we know there's 20 volts here with respect to ground. So we only have one unknown node, which is what we're after, Vx. So I'm going to define a current going like that that I'll call I1. And a current like this that I'll label I2. And this current's already defined for us going into the node. So our KCL equation. This is KCL at Vx. It's just that I have I1 flowing in, and actually, I don't know what that little dot is. Let's just write it over here. I1. We have I1 flowing in. We also have current Vx over 10 flowing in, and that's going to equal I2. And then I1 in terms of voltage is going to be 20 minus Vx over 20. And we got plus Vx over 10. And then I2 is just going to be Vx over 4. Okay, so now if I just multiply through by 20, I'll get 20 minus Vx plus 2Vx. What's that going to be? This is going to equal 5Vx, correct? 5Vx. Okay, and then we have 20. And let's see. This is going to give us plus Vx, move it to the other side, it's going to be 4Vx. So So Vx is just equal to 5 volts. Okay, so you see that's the voltage at node Vx with respect to ground due to these two sources, the voltage source along with the dependent source. Okay, now we have to find Vx due to our current source along with the dependent source. So again, I'm going to use node voltage method. This bottom node is ground. Oop. All of this is ground. Right, because all this, I'll hash it in here. Okay, so all this here is ground. And then we just have the one other node, which is node Vx. Okay, so this is where I need to write my node voltage expression, right at this node Vx. So I'm going to define a current like this that I'll call I1. And I'll define a current down to that 4 ohm that I'll call I2. Okay, then I do my KCL. And we've got 4 amps flowing in, plus Vx over 10 flowing in. And that's going to equal I1 plus I2 flowing out. Okay, so now 4 plus Vx over 10. I1, in terms of voltage, is going to be Vx over 20. And I2 is just going to be Vx over 4. Okay, because remember, ground is this whole node here, what I hashed in. All of that is our ground node. Okay, solve this. I'm going to multiply through by 20. So this is 80 plus 2Vx equal to Vx plus 5Vx. So let's see, 6Vx minus 2Vx, that's 4Vx equal to 80. So Vx is just 20 volts. Okay, so that's the voltage Vx at this node, Vx with respect to ground, due to, here's Vx. So the voltage at this node Vx with respect to ground, 20 volts due to the current source along with the dependent source. So that means our total answer, okay, so total, actually we'll write it over here. Okay, our total, since the polarity is the same, that in both cases Vx came out to a positive voltage. So since they have the same polarity, we just add them up, that the total will just be 20 plus 5, 25 volts. That's our total Vx. Okay, so the key point in this lecture was that when you have a dependent source, you can't eliminate them. So you're going to have the dependent source in all of your circuits along with one independent source, and that when you have a dependent source along with another source, I mean, as long as you have two of any type of sources, you're not going to be able to use voltage divider or current divider, that technique. You're either going to have to use node voltage method or mesh current method. I would recommend for extra practice that you go through and solve both of these superposition circuits with mesh current, and make sure you get the same answer.